Ready for a fish room update? I know Cheeto is. Stay tuned. Hey YouTube, it's Brian and I'm coming at you with a fish room update for October 2017. And we'll just kind of go through everything like we always do. Start up in the office here with Cheeto's tank today. He's doing real good. Still has a couple of girlfriends in there with him. No spawning activity yet. The loaches are still in here and doing well. Yeah, that's really about it for this guy. He is as friendly and playful as ever. Would be kind of nice to get him paired off with a female, but as I've always said, it's not not my first priority with this fish. So I guess we'll move on. The 90-gallon planted tank has still not been redone. Just keep running into more and more things that keep me busy, and I haven't had time to take a day and tear this thing apart and redo it, so it looks like garbage. But we've still got fish, shrimp, and live plants in it, and they're doing good. They just don't look scaped nicely or anything like that. So, but that's what I can tell you about that tank. We'll go downstairs now and take a look at the rest. And like always too, I will let you guys know or remind you that I do sell Southern Delight fish food now. Here's a little sticker. I sell Southern Delight fish food in bulk and bottles. Email me at the address in the description area below if you are looking to order some, and I can get you hooked up with some of this awesome food, like this large cichlid here that I feed this awesome flower horn colossus. This is a 9.9 confa. Guy is just full of personality and awesomeness. Still just really enjoy having this fish down here. A little side. Look at that awesome pattern and coloration on the nuchal hump and throughout the whole body. Just really can't say enough good things about this fish. Really happy that I got him. Going back to the stickers too, got this one, Aquatic Support Systems, and Southern Delight. I include these now in all orders of Southern Delight, and if you previously ordered from me before I got these stickers and want some for your tanks, shoot me an email and I'll get some out to you. Otherwise, if you're going to reorder again soon, I'll just include some in that order. Down below is Cheeto's brother, still doing good. Still have this female in here with them, and no spawning activity whatsoever, and that's just fine. These guys are doing really good. I'd like to get them in a bigger tank at some point. I've got a few ideas about that, but probably won't happen anytime soon. Behind us here is my one Moda left that I have from the handful that I was able to fry from my old pair that I was able to get. I'm not sure yet if this is a male or female. I'm pretty sure it's probably a male because it's killed everything else that has been in here with it as far as the other Modas. Definitely is dominant, and it's just looking super good at this point. Probably about a 3-incher and has all sorts of attitude and just always likes to eat, and as I said before, attacks anything that was in the tank with it. Down below I've got some more Modas that I actually just picked up the day that I'm filming this from my buddy James Randall. These are from his pair, which I don't remember the exact lineage and how they're related, but they are related to the pair I had. They come from Sean Hayden, hands down the best guy to get Modas from. So I'm excited to grow some of these out and see what ends up happening. And you never know. So I'm pretty excited to get my hands on these, and we're just going to let them grow out in this 75-gallon for a while and see what happens. About 30 of them down there, so real cool. Got this guy over here. He is a red magma flower horn, and still doing real good. Just kind of a nice wet pet to have. Yeah, not much more to say about this guy, I guess, but there we go. Redis latest pair. Still doing well. Haven't had any breeding activity since the last video, although as you can see her tube is down now. That has happened before with nothing though, so who knows. But these guys are doing really good. They're just in a bad spot to film as far as getting light reflections from these tanks over here. So down here is one of the two Hadiensis tanks. This is the male. Female is hiding. They spawned recently and there's still one. A couple of little fry in here from their last spawn, but they spawned recently and I'm not sure if the eggs ever made it or if they ate them, but she's been hiding, so I'm suspecting that she's got a pile of wigglers somewhere that any day she'll kind of, I'm trying to see if she's in these tubes, but she's not. After the eggs were laid on this rock, and after they were gone, she spent a lot of time back here by that sponge, so suspecting there may be some soon-to-be free swimmers back there. But in the meantime, we'll have a look at the male. This guy's just awesome. That coloration in the body and the fins and everything. She's really cool too. She's just a nice jet black. Oh, there she is. Looks like she might have a little lip damage, like they may have been lip locking recently. I can't see if there's wigglers down there. Maybe. I don't know. Anyway. Still have the male Moda from Sean. If you remember, or if you're new to this channel, he killed his really nice female several months ago now, and I've just been kind of keeping him soloed, decide what I want to do. You'll also remember that before he killed her, she had taken a good chunk out of his tail. It's made some really good progress growing back, but it hasn't grown back all the way. I'd kind of given up on it, but then I've noticed that slowly it's still been growing some, and I attribute that to some super large water changes and also her not being with him to continue to nibble on it. His colors aren't nearly as good without a female in there, but he's still a great fish. So down below here is the other Hadiensis tank. Also a nice looking pair. They've still got probably 15 or so fry in here. There's one in the back from the last batch. Whoops. And it was a huge spawn because I pulled a bunch, and I still have a bunch that I'll show you. There's some more down between these tubes there, but they've been acting really weird lately and hiding out a lot. They like to hide back in this corner. Haven't seen any spawning activity. But hopefully they kind of start coming back to their normal selves and being out and interactive. Show you, still got Orion here. Gotta always get some shots of him. I accidentally zoomed in there, sorry. So if you're new to this channel, this is a Parachromis dovi. He's an old guy. I don't know exactly how old he is, but this guy was originally with Gage Brady, and then Mike Mann had him, and Mike had him for at least 5 years, I think, before I got him. I'm coming up on a year now since I've had him, I think. In a couple of months, it should be a year. Look at that. There's the female. His name's Orion, if I didn't already say that, and she's Artemis. They recently spawned. You can see a big pile of wigglers back there. As always, thousands of them. She's a little beat up on her, in her face, I guess. They were doing a lot of lip locking before they spawned, and there was a couple times I would see that her whole head was basically in his big cake hole. But that's nothing new for this pair. Up above are the F1 Real Mag Umbies, Matrix, and Optimus. Or excuse me, that, but this is Matrix, the female. Optimus is the male. Matrix is, I forget the lineage, I've got it written down. Optimus is from Magnus and Beast, Mike Mann's pair. These guys are quite the specimens, and they're close to spawning. She's fat and full of eggs and had a bunch of fry. Just about a week ago, I finally pulled them so that they could spawn again. And I'll show you them in a little bit. But yeah, they're looking really good. Really happy to own this pair. Yeah, sorry about all the reflections and everything there. She's a little darker than usual right now, but lately she's been pretty much pure blonde with the spawning dress, I guess, if you will. Anyway, we'll move over here. Sorry, I scared these guys all away, but as you can see, I've got a bunch of Haitiensis that I've pulled. I've got some up in this 75 gallon. I've got a bunch right here. And a bunch right here. So these guys are starting to get to the point, maybe another month or so, hopefully, that I'll be ready to start shipping some. Here's the umbies that I pulled. Pretty small. And then I pulled some dovi from the last spawn. I pulled just a net full one day because they were starting to eat them. You know, it's so funny. That pair, their spawns are huge, like clutches of like over 1,000, and they just end up eating them. You know, when Mike had them, I would go over to his house and visit, and there'd be large fry in there. Like they used to let them live quite a bit, but for whatever reason, they don't do that anymore. So if I don't pull them pretty quick, they always end up eating them. But then they spawn again fairly quickly after that, so. Anyway, a lot of black nasties. That were growing out here. So, that's really about it. As always, I'll do a separate shrimp update for those of you guys that are interested in my shrimp. I'm gonna take you over here real quick. Just grab. I already talked about these, but once again, here's some of the stickers that I'll be shipping with Southern Delight orders, so expect those when you order. So yeah, thanks everybody for watching as always. I appreciate all the subscribers and appreciate all the questions and comments, and I really appreciate those of you that have ordered Southern Delight. And yeah, I'm getting to the point now where I've done it for a few months and I'm getting some repeat orders and stuff like that, so it really means a lot that that you guys are supporting this great fish food, helping support me a little bit in selling it. And I'm really proud that I can have it, that we can continue to have it in bulk out in the hobby, because for a while it looked like that may not happen anymore. So I'm really proud to be able to make such a great food available to all you guys. So if you've got any questions, let me know. If you're new to this channel and you want to see more videos like this, make sure that you hit that subscribe button. And until next time, thanks a lot. Oh, make sure you go over on Facebook too to the Aquatic Support System business page and then the Aquatic Support Community group as well, and get involved in both of those. And thanks for watching.